In the ReMoCapp application, navigate to the Application Settings tab. Leave the default value for max FPS as it is. Since the receiver is on the same machine as the ReMoCapp application, you can also leave the default value for the IP address field. From the skeleton drop-down menu, select UE5 Mani / Quinn, as we will be using UE5 Mani, compatible with UE5 skeleton, in our scene for this example. If you want to save your configurations, such as app and camera settings, as well as the layout, you can use the export button located at the top right section of the application window. You can import the saved configurations the next time you start the application. Choose Fast CPU from the available options, which determines the application AI mode when capturing actor motions. Now, switch back to the Unreal Editor. Click anywhere in the viewport and press F11 to maximize the viewport. Press Alt plus P to start playing the level. To access the recording options, click the button at the top left corner of the screen. From there, you can set the scene name and countdown values. The scene name value will be included in the exported file names. The countdown value specifies how much time to wait before starting a recording. By clicking the yellow button at the top right of the window, you will be presented with the shortcut keys for recording and controlling the actor cameras. Switch back to the ReMoCapp application and click the Run button to start capturing motions. This will initiate the motion capture process. Now, switch back to the Unreal Editor and click the Recording button to start recording the animations. Since we have set the countdown to off, the recording will start immediately. The ReMoCapp application will send the motion data to the specified address, and the ReMoCapp plugin in Unreal Engine will receive the data and animate the character in real time accordingly. To finish the recording, click the Stop button. Once the animation processing is completed, a notification will appear, displaying the exported FBX file path. Additionally, an animation sequence asset will be created in Unreal Engine. While the Unreal Editor is still in focus, press Shift plus Escape to stop playing. Then press F11 to restore the viewport size. Next, click to open the content drawer and navigate to the animations folder within the plugin's content directory. By default, the animation sequence asset is saved in this folder. Double-click on the animation sequence asset to open it. This will open the animation editor window, where you can make further modifications to the animation as needed. Open the Projects folder in the File Explorer. You should be able to locate an exported animations folder. You will find the FBX file of the recorded animation in this folder. This file can be imported and edited in various digital content creation applications. Congratulations on completing our ReMoCapp tutorial series. Remember to continue exploring and experimenting. We can't wait to see the incredible animations you'll create. If you found our tutorials helpful and want to stay updated with the latest tips, tricks, and tutorials on ReMoCapp, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We love hearing from our community. If you have any questions or suggestions or want to share your work, feel free to join our Discord channel using the link provided in the description. ReMoCapp is still in beta version, and as the features are being developed and added to the application gradually, we will provide more videos and learning resources whenever required. We're here to support you on your motion capture journey. Thank you so much, and see you next time.